Welcome to the 10 Pin Bowling Show. This week we have a singles match in the Big Clash, and it is between Matt Riley for 10 Pin City and Daniel Webb for Interbowl. Now we cross to our commentators.
Thank you, Simon, and welcome to all viewers of this week's edition of the 10 Pin Bowling Show. I'm Michael Tran, along with Brenton Davey, bringing to you the New South Wales State League Big Clash between 10 Pin City and Interbowl. Our 10 Pin City team consists of Glenn Rowland, Jason Osborne. Last week you saw Andrew Lloyd bowl. This week you will be seeing Matthew Riley and Glenn Loader.
And for Interbowl, at leadoff, Kevin Webb. Christian Perdue at two. Sam Cooley at three. This week you'll see the youngster Daniel Webb. And next week, Dale Fitzgerald.
Great lineups there. And if you were watching last week, 10 Pin City notched up their first win. It is 2-1 to Interbowl. As we introduce Daniel Webb from the Interbowl team, he has a 300 game to his credit. Let's have a look at what he's got to bring to the show. Very traditional style shot. And nice result there, carrying all 10.
Very nice result. Matthew Riley, dual Australian Open winner. Current league average of 226, has a total of 18 300 games to his credit, has represented Australia on numerous times. This guy throws a great shot. Let's have a look at this.
Have a look, viewers. Plenty of rotation, plenty of speed. This particular instance, not finding the pocket quite as flush as he'd like. It's a little bit light leaving your 2-8.
If Matt has a downfall, sometimes he tries too hard to overpower the revs with ball speed. You saw there, ball just went a little bit too long down the lane. Didn't quite make it back, leaves the 2 and sleeper 8.
Not a bad opening shot though. We'll see how his spare form is. That's very encouraging. Close frames all round so far. And we're going to have a look at the trophy. The New South Wales State League Big Clash trophy. That's what the teams are bowling for, folks. Nice piece of silverware. Now Dan to open his account in the second frame. Boy, this really warms up to be a fantastic match. You've got the youngster Daniel Webb, who's got three Southern New South Wales President Shield team to his credit, versus the very experienced campaigner in Matthew Riley. Great second shot. That's flush.
Oh, likes it too. A little bit in the veteran's face there.
He loves it. In high tents to the crowd, I think, on the way back. Let's have a look at this shot.
And I think he was letting Matt Riley know that he's going to give him all he can handle. See how Matt responds. Not averse to a little bit of gamesmanship himself on occasion.
No, he's been here many a time before. A second shot.
That's a better shot.
As he moves across the camera face there, but I can guarantee that was dead flush.
Gotta like that one. Snap the 10 pin out. Have a look at this one. 6 pin does the work off the wall.
Nice angle of entry and the ball doing the job. Getting through. All 10 pins down.
Now Daniel looking for a turkey to stretch that lead out.
And boy, wouldn't this be a magnificent start from the youngster.
Certainly showing no nerves under the TV lights thus far.
He knows how to throw it, folks. He has a 210 average in league currently, as a high three-game series of 826, but that shot, not good at all.
Looked like he snatched at that one just a little bit at the bottom of the swing. I don't think there was too much wrong with the line. I think he just snatched out at the bottom of the swing. That caused it to break a bit early on him. I think he'll just go hard and straight at two here.
Yeah, do the team play and keep the count up. Goes at the two, like you said. No deflection, but that's team bowling. Takes as many as he can. Take your medicine. Work on that in the next frame.
Might have been a little bit too much adrenaline after that opening double.
Boy, he was looking good, wasn't he?
He was. Back in Matt's face a little bit there. Might have been just a little too much adrenaline. Now the shoe's on the other foot, and Matt can throw a strike here to take a big lead.
Whoa!
Holy moly, that was wide.
I think he knew it straight off the hand. He was kind of hoping for something. But boy, gave that some room. Missing the head pin altogether, and you don't see that very often from Matt Riley.
No, certainly not on this sort of lane condition too, Matt. You know, give him a little bit of room to the right, and he'll normally take full advantage of it. But that one, he didn't catch that one at all, I don't think.
Now he's taken six and's left with four plus a head pin. And that is textbook. You do not take him any cleaner than that.
Have a look at this. Ball crosses over. Takes the one and the two. The two goes back onto the eight. And the four goes as well. Now, Daniel needs to fight back. That's a bit wide as well.
Back-to-back splits for Daniel Webb. And maybe a few nerves coming in.
A few nerves. Possibly two, seeing as the previous shot went high. He might have made an adjustment. Just goes to show that if you make an errant shot, you don't adjust off it. You try and execute the next one on the same target. If you need to make an adjustment after that, then you do. But
you're saying he's over-adjusted to a bad shot, but have a look at the recovery, folks. That's a brilliant spare. Great shot. Have a look at this. He's caught that two-pin flush in the diagonal and taken care of the 10. You don't beat him any better than that. Great spare under pressure.
Magnificent shot under pressure. And needed it because if he opens that one, then Matt's got a huge advantage.
Oh! Gets some help. Shows it back to the opposition. Gets high in the pocket. Lovely 10. We'll be right back. And welcome back to all viewers of this week's edition of the 10 Pin Bowling Show. My name's Michael Tran with Brenton Davey, bringing to you the New South Wales State League Big Clash from Lidcombe 10 Pin City. That was George's bowling tips, and I'll tell you what, these guys here, they know how to hook a ball, but it did not happen overnight. Daniel Webb, say for instance, he's been bowling 13 years, and he's only 17 years of age. That's how you do it, folks. Lovely shot there, all 10 down.
Daniel, while not throwing the massive number of revs, you wouldn't call him a stroker either. He's just got that nice balance of rhythm and revs. And on today's conditions with today's equipment, that can be a very, very dangerous combination.
And this is the other extreme. This is Matt Riley throwing plenty of rotation, plenty of speed, getting the same result. He's happy with that one. Best shot of the match.
Have a look at that one. Again, hankering maybe just to climb a hair high, but the head pin takes the four and the seven out. And that double effectively gives him a 15-pin lead.
Yes, he is working on the double, and of course, if you're working on strikes, the next two shots count. Now, up to Daniel and the top of the sixth. Ooh, lovely shot.
That one was really clean through the bottom of the swing. Just nice and aggressive through the bottom of the swing. Nice extension. 10 in the pit.
Well, I think the 5-pin did the job on the 9 there. The ball was going straight through. Lucky to catch that one. But you'll take them all. And he's building up a decent head of steam here. He's showing it to the big fella.
Matt's an experienced campaigner, though.
Ooh. That was light in, but did the job, got the carry.
Yeah, same line again, just a little bit more ball speed on that. Big, aggressive shot. And he's back to that 15-pin lead. Daniel needs to stay with him. And I can tell you from personal experience, if you let Matt Riley get away from you, you'll never reel him in.
He's a very, very hard man to stop once he gets his rhythm going. Daniel may find that very soon. But let's see what he can do. He's got to keep piling on the strikes.
Another aggressive shot through the bottom of the swing. He's been pretty fearless the last three shots. Let's have a look at this one. Big follow through, big extension. They say trust is a must or your game is a bust. Well, he trusted that one.
A good one. He's getting enough momentum through the ball. It's just taking out the five pin. And the pin reaction is doing the rest. Now Matt Riley to stay with the youngster.
Oh!
Could have been something nasty. Nice clean shot. But sometimes that's the price you pay with having all those revolutions. The pins tend not to hit each other.
That's definitely overpowering the deck right there.
Now, pins have a funny way of jumping around and not sort of meeting each other, but he's left a seven pin here.
Needs to make it to maintain a lead.
Well, it should be regulation, and certainly is. Taking the spare. But, folks, what we have is a potential four-pin match. This is going to go right down to the wire.
And for first time on TV, young Daniel's looking quite cool, calm and collected.
Very composed, isn't he? I'm impressed. Nice steady approach, five step.
That's swings. A bit quick.
Oh, he got away with nine. Good result.
Bit quick. It looks like you get it a bit wide, gets into the dry bit early. That almost looks as if it just rolled out. So obviously that if you get a little bit too wide, there's definitely a problem getting it back to the pocket.
And going the hard case plastic ball at the single pin. Now there's a different method altogether. A lot of people opt to take the reactive ball and try and hook it into anything on the left hand side. Daniel obviously has enough trust in his shot to be able to throw the ball straight.
Now, did Matt consider picking up another ball then? I mean, he's been hitting the pocket and was unlucky not to strike the last time, but looks like he's just maybe a touch indecisive which ball he wants to use. See what happens here.
Oh boy, he shouldn't be after that shot. Great shot. Fist pump. Great emotion. Good shot. We'll be right back after these short messages. And welcome to everybody back to the 2010 New South Wales State League Big Clash. Tenpin Bowling Show's coverage. Michael Tran's my name, accompanied by Brenton Davey. And at the top of the ninth frame, we have Daniel Webb. This game's tightening up. Daniel potentially has a five-pin deficit. And that shot, maybe it's a little bit tentative. Last couple haven't quite made it back to the pocket. Notice that five pin's only just tipping over.
And that tells me the ball's rolling out. That tells me that the ball's rolling out. It's losing energy as it's going through the pin deck. It looks like Daniel especially just needs to tighten the lineup.
He does have a great spare game on his side, however. Saves a spare. And now Matt Riley, I tell you what. If he can somehow put on a strike, he goes into the 10th frame with a lot of confidence.
Oh, he'll be looking to jump all over this one. Get that lead back out.
Oh! Oh my goodness, that could have been so different. He knows it too. Slaps a thigh.
That half pocket at last few frames really hasn't been good to him. Nearly left a 7-10 couple of frames ago. Comes back, leaves a 7 off a half pocket hit. And it's a six-pin match going into the 10th. Daniel wants to get up now and throw three really good shots here, but he cannot shut out Matt Riley.
Cannot shut out Matt Riley, and Matt's been here plenty of times before. He knows exactly what he needs to do. The higher-level bowlers tend to calculate the score and all the possibilities, which sometimes can be a disadvantage because it adds a bit more pressure, but Daniel marching up, putting in a brilliant shot. That's probably his best shot of the game, I'd say.
Could well be a little more direct on that one.
The ball turned up.
He held the oil line just a little bit longer, so it didn't roll out. Now needs this one to really put some pressure on Matt Riley.
That's wide. Oh! You were saying before, Brenton, light pocket hits, not carrying. Normally they do. but that's not a bad shot.
Again, it just looks like it's rolling out. And when it rolls out, the ball loses its energy. The pins don't quite fly around the same way.
It was unlucky for that head pin to come out and chop the four out, but he's missed the spare in any case. It might not have mattered.
Doesn't make a lot of difference.
Now,
but Matt Riley needs to fill 14 pins.
Any kind of mark from Matt Riley, and you'd expect him to keep the ball on the lane and the fill ball, but we'll get past this bit first.
See what happens.
Whoa. Oh, no.
Oh, dear.
Uh-oh.
Must go back and must make this spare. If he does not make this spare, Daniel Webber's the winner of this match. And that would be a huge win for Interbowl.
That one kind of went out the window, didn't it? But Daniel spared this once before today. How's it go?
Oh,
tried to get the deflection off the back. It wasn't enough. Daniel Webb comes up 212 to 206. And the home side trail Interbowl to the scoreline of 1-3.
Thanks for your company today, and we look forward to seeing you next week. Good luck in bowling.